Assalamualaikum. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. I'm your instructor, Dr. Arbooz Hamid. Today's topic of my lecture is solution preparation. This is the practical course. Biochemistry of carbohydrate is actually a practical course, and regarding the practical activity, the first topic about the practical activity is solution preparation. Because you know, all knows that all the practicals of any class of any depending upon the solutions preparation. Without the use of solutions, we are unable to do any type of practicals. So by taking the different examples of solutions, we can understand about how do we prepare solutions. The difficulty for research is also based upon the solutions preparations. Many students have problems regarding the preparation of different solutions. I want to assure you to keep an eye upon the solution preparation problems. First of all, we will talk about what is solutions. Which thing is actually called as solutions? Solution is actually a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. It is actually a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. One is the solute and the other is the solvent. We not only says that the one is the we not only says that it is a dry chemical. It can be a liquid. Solute may be a liquid or may be a dry chemical. Both are called as the solutes, and the second one is the solvent, which is needed in which this solute molecule has been dissolved. Homogeneous mixtures mean the both components are homogenized with each other. They are no particle would be seen by naked eye. Every particle of the dry material or every particle of the liquid solute material must to be dissolved fully in solvent molecule. Then this is called as the solution. What type of solutions are existed, and or what type of solutions we have to made in during different research activities? Person solutions. Molar solutions, number one is the Pearson solutions, number two is the molar solutions, and number three is the normal solutions. Regarding the name of these types of solutions, you have considered that it is a very easy task to make a Pearson solution, or it is a very easy task to make a molar solution, or to make a normal solution. But actually, these are not the very easy task to make the all these solutions. You have to calculate the exact amount of the solute which would be dissolved in the solution. In the solute molecule to form the solutions. So calculations are very important for the formation of different types of solutes. If you have idea about the calculations, then you can easily make different types of solutions by your own. First of all we discussed the Pearson solution. As it is shown by the name, the Pearson solutions are many chemical solutions are mixed as Pearson solutions. When you are working with a dry material, you have to you have to calculate the amount of the dry chemical, the dry solute in grams, which would be dissolved in 100 ml of the solvent. Then this is called as the 1% solution of that dry chemical. It means when we say 1% solution, we have to make 1% solution of a dry chemical. We have to make 1 gram we have to weigh the 1 gram of dry chemical and dissolve this material into and dissolve this material into hundred milliliter of solvent is called as the 1% solution of that dry chemical. This is actually called as the weight by volume percent solutions. These are actually called as the weight by volume percent solutions. Weight by volume percent solutions. Regardless of the molecular weight or the formula weight of the dry chemical, we only choose the percent of the solution which we made. Only the grams of 1%, if it is 1%, we choose 1 gram of dry chemical, and if it is 2%, then we choose 2 grams of that dry chemical, and if it is 3%, then we choose 3 grams of dry chemical, depending upon the percentage required to be made. Regardless of the formula weight or the molecular weight of that dry chemical, it may be of 200 kilo, it may be of 200, it may be 200, it may be of 300, it may be of 58, it may be of 50 grams, it may be of 54 grams, whatever the formula weight, whatever the molecular weight, we only choose the equal grams of dry chemical which are dissolved for the formation of the desired percentage. As I say earlier, 1% solution of a dry chemical means 1 gram of that dry chemical to be dissolved in every time they are dissolved in 100 ml of the solvents for making the percent solutions, regardless of the volume. But they are also regardless of the volume, they are not dissolved in 1000 ml, they are not dissolved in any other amount. They are only dissolved, 1% means they are only dissolved in 100 ml of the solvent. So making of the percent solutions are very easy task if you have the idea about the calculations. First of all, I give some examples regarding this weight by volume percent solutions. If I want to say we have to meet 2.5% of sodium chloride solution, also if we say that we have to make 2.5% of sodium chloride solution. Also, the volume is given, the 200 ml of 2.5% of sodium chloride solution to be made. Then what we will do to make this solution? 2.5%. 5% means 2.5 grams of sodium chloride are to be taken. Regardless of that, the sodium chloride have the formula weight 58.5 grams. There is no need of this formula weight, there is no need of this molecular weight of the sodium chloride. We only choose 2.5 grams of sodium chloride. And if we have made 100 ml and dissolve it in 100 ml, this is actually the 2.5% solution. But we have to make 200 ml of that solution. So that's why 100 ml of sodium chloride solution contains 2.5 grams of sodium chloride. Two point five percent sodium chloride solution. If we dissolve 2.5 grams of sodium chloride in 100 ml, then it is 2.5% solution of sodium chloride. But we needed 200 ml of 2.5% sodium chloride solution. For this one, 100 ml contains 2.5 gram sodium chloride. By percent, by unit formula, we calculate the amount of sodium chloride 1 ml contains 2.5 by 100 and 200 ml contains 2.5 by 100 into 200. It would be 5 grams. The calculated amount is 5 grams now. So we have calculate 5 grams by using weighing balance, 5 grams of sodium chloride, and dissolve it in 200 ml of distilled water. The solution made is 2.5% sodium chloride solution of 200 ml. For making the homogeneous mixture of this sodium chloride solution, you guys have better idea. You shouldn't measure 200 ml of distilled water exactly and pour 5 grams of sodium chloride in it. No, this is not the way to make a homogeneous mixture of the solution. For making For making a homogeneous mixture or clear solution of the sodium chloride, you must have to dissolve this desired amount, 5 grams of sodium chloride, firstly in lower amount of distilled water, for example in 100 ml or in 150 ml. Then after when the whole amount of the dry matter, the dry material, the dry chemical, the sodium chloride dissolved in this volume of distilled water, then you have to make the volume of that solution to up to 200 ml by using the measuring cylinder. By this way you can get the homogeneous mixture of this solution. Second type of this percent solutions are volume by volume percent solutions. Volume by volume percent solutions. Volume by volume percent solutions. As it is known by the name, when we talk about the volume by volume percent solutions, then we have an idea about that both the solute and the solvents are in volume concentration. When the formula includes a liquid chemical, then the percent solution is volume added chemical in ml made up to 100 ml with solvent. So in this case we choose the ml amount regardless of the gram amounts of the dry chemical. In it we choose the liquid because we choose the liquid chemical which has been dissolved in the solvent, so we choose the amount of that liquid chemical in volume milliliter and dissolve it into 100 ml of solvent to make that percent solution, which is called as volume by volume percent solutions. For example, if we have to make 10% acetic acid solution, we have to choose 10 ml of acetic acid and now dissolved it in 90 ml of distilled water. Because in this case the both solute and solvents are liquid, so to make 100 ml of solution we have to remove that amount of solute from the exact volume of that solution. If it is 10%, then 10 ml of acetic acid dissolved in 90 ml of water regardless of 100 ml of water in case of weight by volume percent solutions. By taking this idea about the percent solutions, you have know about how can we prepare the different types of percent solutions of different amounts. Similarly, if we have to make 10%, 200 ml of 10% acetic acid solution, then what would we do? Two hundred ml of 10% acetic acid solution. 10 ml. Acetic acid hundred ml of acetic acid solution contains 10 ml of acetic acid, 1 ml contains 10 by 100 ml, and 200 ml contains 10 by 100. Ten by 100 into 200. 20 ml. So in this case, you have to dissolve 20 ml of acetic acid in 180 ml of distilled water to make 200 ml of 10% acetic acid solution. Next, we talk about the molar solutions. Second type of solution preparation is of molar solutions. In case of molar solutions, if we want to bait one molar solution of a compound, we have to weigh the formula weight of that chemical dissolved in 1 liter of the solvent or distilled water, then this is a 1 molar solution of that chemical. The formula weight is given either on the chemical bottle, or you can use the molecular weight of the that chemical as the formula weight if formula weight is not given. 1 molar solution of for example sodium chloride is actually, first of all we calculate the molecular weight of sodium chloride, 23 plus 35.5 is equal to 58.5 grams of sodium chloride is the molecular weight of that chemical. To make 1 molar solution of sodium chloride, we have to weigh 58.5 grams of sodium chloride and dissolved it in 1000 ml or 1 liter, then it would be called as 1 molar solution of sodium chloride. It is equal to the 1 molar solution of sodium chloride. By taking different examples, we can get idea about the molar solutions. Molar solutions. If we have to prepare 2 liters of 0.2 molar solution of a chemical having फॉर्मूला वेट वेट ऑफ 154.2 ग्राम्स पर मोल. हाउ मेनी ग्राम्स ऑफ द केमिकल डू वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर दैट सॉल्यूशन? One 54.2 grams dissolved per liter is equal to 1 molar solution. But we have needed 0.2 molar solution. So we have to multiply this 0.2 with the formula weight 154.2 grams. The calculated amount is 54.2 30.84 grams. This amount has been dissolved in 1 liter, then it is a 0.2 molar that solution, but we need 2 liters, so we have to multiply this amount with 2 and we get the amount of 60. We get the amount of 61.68 grams of that chemical to be dissolved. 61.68 grams of that chemical would be dissolved in 2 liter of the solvent or 2 liter of the distilled water, then it made the solution of 2 liters of 0.2 molar this dry chemical. But similarly, as it is earlier suggested, you have not taken the 2 liter amount of distilled water as such. You have to first dissolve this 61.68 grams of chemical in lower amount. It may be of 1 liter, it may be of 1500 ml, or it may be of 1800 ml. And after dissolving this chemical thoroughly, or after making the homogeneous mixture of that chemical in it, you should have to combine. And by the using the measuring cylinder, you have then you have made the volume up to 2 liter, up to 2000 ml of that solution. Similarly, different types of solutions of molar concentration can be made. And if you have to take a solution as a stock solution and have to convert it into other solutions, dilutions, you have to use of the chemical formula for making these dilutions, which we have discussed in our next lectures on the topic of solution preparations. First of all, I recall again, you have studied today the solution preparation of percent solutions, which are of two types: weight by volume percent solutions, and second one are the volume by volume percent solutions. you can go through this lecture, and also you have choose some type of I give you some at the end I give you some examples or some questions to be solved. By solving these problems or questions, you can have the idea about how can you made the percent solutions and how can you made the molar solutions. I give you three questions regarding the percent solutions and three questions regarding the molar solutions. First of all, for the percent solutions, you have to make 300 ml of 0.45% sodium chloride solution. Second is, you have to make 700 ml of 0.75% sodium chloride solution. Third is, you have to make 150 ml of 1.5% sodium chloride solution. You have to solve these problems. How can you made all these three solutions? We have discussed it later on. What will be you have by solving these problems? I can understand you got what idea about the percent solutions. Three examples of molar solutions now. You have to make 300 ml of 0.4 molar sodium chloride solution. Second is 750 ml of 1.2 molar solution of sodium chloride solution. Third one is 450 ml of 0.75 molar sodium chloride solution. By solving these problems, you can get the idea about the molar solutions. How can you prepare the molar solutions and how can you prepare the percent solutions? Any questions regarding this solution preparation lecture, you can ask me in comments, or you can use the Gmail account. You can WhatsApp me your questions regarding this solution preparations. Thank you so very much for your patience and for your time. Thank you so very much. We will be talk about in our next lectures about the solution preparations, inshallah. Allah Hafiz.
Please speak English.